Gentlemen, if, like me, you're a man who's getting on a bit in years, and you find that you just don't have as good a memory as you once had, that your motivation is slipping and your focus is fading, and you've decided to do something about it by exploring nootropics, then you'll want to watch this video. This is Lance, and I'd like to welcome you back to my second video on nootropics. As many of you know, I created this channel as a way to record what I've learned, the plans that I've made, and the results that I've obtained, all in the quest to turn back the clock. And turning back the clock on cognitive decline is very near the top of my list. So I decided to create this three-part series on nootropics. In the first video in this series, I talked about how the brain functions and introduced the subject of nootropics, gave a bit of history, and listed some of the benefits of taking nootropics. Now, if you missed that video, I put a link to it in the description below, as well as a link to the final video in this series, in which I discuss how to take nootropics and the benefits that I personally achieved from them. In this video, I'm going to start off by examining some of the different types of neurotransmitters, the role that they play in cognitive function, and the effects that various nootropics have on these various neurotransmitters. Then I'll get into a discussion of the various classes of nootropics and list the benefits associated with each. There are a lot of different types of nootropics, and they can affect a lot of the different aspects of cognitive function. And it can be a bit daunting, trying to figure out which ones are best for you. Now, in this video, I'm going to briefly touch on most of them, but I'm not going to go into a whole lot of detail in the interest of keeping this video relatively short. I'll be putting up videos in the future where I go into more detail with regard to specific nootropics. And by the way, this is by no means a comprehensive list. One website that I frequent lists 88 different compounds as nootropics, and I know of some nootropics that are not listed on that website. But before I begin, I'd like to talk for a moment about some of the different neurotransmitters and the roles that they play in mental function. The first of these is serotonin. Serotonin is a neurotransmitter which is derived from the amino acid tryptophan. It's usually considered to be a mood enhancer and is usually associated with feelings of happiness and well-being. But it can also modulate cognition, reward, learning, and memory. Now, next is dopamine. Dopamine is derived from its precursor chemical, L-DOPA, which is synthesized in the brain and in the kidneys. Now, in popular culture, dopamine is considered to be the pleasure neurotransmitter, but it can also affect reward-motivated behavior and motivation, the fine-tuning of motor functions and compulsions. Next, GABA, or gamma-aminobutyric acid. Now, this is a neurotransmitter produced by glutamate in the brain. GABA is considered an inhibitory neurotransmitter because it prevents other neurotransmitters from being released, causing a calming or anti-anxiety effect. And finally, we come to acetylcholine, which is a neurotransmitter critical for encoding new memories, reasoning, concentration, cognition, and the growth of new synapses, which is also known as neuroplasticity. Now, acetylcholine can't cross the blood-brain barrier, so it must be synthesized within the brain. Some nootropics, upon crossing the blood-brain barrier and entering the brain, separate into compounds that can produce more acetylcholine and others that increase the uptake of acetylcholine into the brain. Now, additionally, I want to mention brain-derived neurotropic factor, or BDNF. BDNF is a protein that helps support the survival of existing neurons and encourages the growth and differentiation of new neurons and new synapses. So, let's start our discussion of the types of nootropics with caffeine, the most widely used psychoactive drug in the world, and considered a nootropic because when used in moderation, it helps improve reaction time, alertness, memory, concentration, and mood, and it can boost athletic performance by reducing physical and mental fatigue. Caffeine boosts neurotransmitters by influencing acetylcholine, epinephrine or adrenaline, serotonin, and it boosts the use of dopamine. It's also a neuroprotectant, boosting gene expression of brain-derived neurotrophic factor, or BDNF. And caffeine can improve mood because it increases the density of GABA receptors, increases the effects of dopamine, and causes some serotonin receptors to be more responsive. Next are the recetums. So in 1964, the Romanian chemist, Dr. Corneliu Georgia, developed a compound that he named pyrocetum, and he coined the term nootropic to describe it. Pyrocetum was the first of the recetums, and recetums work by boosting acetylcholine receptors in the brain into accepting or being more sensitive to acetylcholine. In addition to pyrocetums, other recetums include oxyrecetum and anorecetum. Okay, so next is creatine. Creatine is produced in the liver and acts as fuel for your cells, including brain cells. After crossing the blood-brain barrier, it binds to phosphate. Now, creatine phosphate fuels energy consumption by the brain, and it's popular because of the high fuel demands by the brain cells when using recetums. So creatine is useful as both muscle fuel and for mental performance, and helps boost memory, reducing brain fatigue, improving mood, and is anti-aging and a neuroprotectant. Next is Noapep, which is a peptide-derived nootropic that is similar to the recetums, but it's 1,000 times more potent than pyrocetum. Now, this doesn't mean that its effect is 1,000 times more powerful, but rather that it only takes 1/1,000th as much to get the same effect. And since, like most nootropics, the effect has an upper limit, taking more won't have any additional effect, but it could impact your tolerance and dependency of the drug. Noapep seems to stimulate dopamine, nicotinic, and serotonin receptors. It's also been shown to increase brain-derived growth factor. Okay, next on our list are the eugeroics, and they include modafinil, armodafinil, and the discontinued adrafinil. Now, eugeroics are a class of drugs that promote wakefulness and alertness, and eugeroics, such as modafinil, enhance dopamine release, but it's not really known at this time exactly how they work. They can improve focus, motivation, clarity, and memory, but because they are metabolized in the liver, they are not recommended for people with liver disease. Okay, now I'm going to talk about acetylcholine, or ACH. As I mentioned earlier, acetylcholine is a neurotransmitter, not a nootropic, that is vital to a whole slew of brain functions. But acetylcholine cannot cross the blood-brain barrier, and so it must be synthesized within the brain. Choline is a precursor to acetylcholine, and CDP choline, or citicholine, is a highly bioavailable source of choline that easily crosses the blood-brain barrier. CDP choline is an effective nootropic on its own, but it also works synergistically to boost the effects of other nootropics, particularly the recetums. Now, GABA is another neurotransmitter that cannot cross the blood-brain barrier. Finabutate, which is a nootropic, is an analog of GABA, and the addition of a phenyl ring allows Finabutate to cross the blood-brain barrier. So neurohackers prefer Finabutate when the goal is to raise GABA levels in the brain. Finabutate has strong anti-anxiety qualities, and it can be used to combat depression, improve mood, cognitive function, and motivation. So L-theanine is another nootropic, which is an amino acid that naturally occurs in green tea and oolong tea, and like GABA, is an anxiolytic, which means that it's useful in reducing anxiety. Now, since it's an amino acid, it easily crosses the blood-brain barrier and works quickly to increase dopamine and serotonin levels. It's often stacked with caffeine to promote cognition, motivation, and attention, and it can reduce caffeine jitters. Next, I'm going to talk about herbal supplements. Now, these include Rhodiola rosea, Panax ginseng, Ginkgo biloba, and others. Most of these herbal supplements are recommended for a variety of other effects beyond just nootropics, but they also have nootropic effects. Now, in my experience, whatever nootropic effects they might have are so subtle as to be imperceptible. Since many of the herbal supplements are recommended for other applications, such as increasing testosterone, I occasionally take them, but they're not really a staple for me. Now, you might experience different effects, so I suggest trying them and see how they work for you. Now, there are a number of proprietary blends on the market, such as Qualia, Alpha Brain, Neuromaster, Keto Prime, and countless others. And to be honest, I've never tried any of them, so I can't really recommend any of them. Now, I'm sure a lot of them are great, but I also suspect that some of the less well-known brands might be just trying to jump on the nootropic bandwagon and don't contain enough active ingredients to be of much use. If you've used any of these products and have had great results, then please tell me about it in the comments below. Finally, there are a few types of nootropics that I don't really recommend. Things like Adderall, which is an amphetamine, Ritalin, which is an ADHD stimulant, and nicotine. While all of these can produce a nootropic effect, they can also have harmful side effects and be habit-forming or addictive. And most, if not all, of their nootropic effects can be duplicated by other nootropics which have no side effects. So, there you have it. The beginning of an understanding into the various types of nootropics. And as you can see, there are a lot of them. And as I mentioned earlier, this is by no means a comprehensive list. There are a lot more chemical compounds out there that can be considered a nootropic. In the next and final video in this series, I'll be talking about how to take nootropics, covering subjects such as dosage, frequency, cycling, stacking. I'll discuss the results that I've personally achieved from taking nootropics. If you enjoyed this video, then please subscribe to my channel, share it with your friends and on your social media, hit the like button and leave a comment, and be sure to hit the bell button to be notified when I post a new video, which should be every Tuesday, with the bonus video on the occasional Fridays. And as always, thank you so much for watching.